Hello and what's up everybody, this is Pete from Speed Academy, and in this video we will be discussing about the operators and its precedence. Guys, what operators are and what is the need of operators? Guys, if you break the word operator into, then you will find a word opera and the another word or, sorry, operate and or. So what operate and or means? Guys, operator means it is a tool which helps you to perform some actions. Okay, operate means you are performing an operation. You are performing an operation, and your term means with the help of some tools. Okay, so we call the tools as your operators, and we have assigned some precedence to each operator, so it will work according to 10 only means. Precedence, you can say that which operator is going to be evaluate its value first. Okay, so I will be telling you how this precedence and operators are to be worked together. So let's just take a deep dive into it and see how to do all this stuff. So I have already created my document file and linked my JavaScript file with it. So I'm gonna write a script over here. Actually, I am not required to write a script over here. I'm directly going to work with your console in the Mozilla or in Chrome. So let's just take a one example, and then we will start working in Mozilla only in the inspector tool. I have main.js file over here. Okay guys, so now I'm going to write a script. Okay, before writing a script, let me just show you that what are the type of operators we have and why operators are important to you. Guys, first thing is that operators are very, very useful in programming. Not in JavaScript only, but in every programming language, operators are there for performing any task. Means if you want to perform an arithmetic operation, then it is required to use an arithmetic operator. So similarly, we have two or three types more in the operators. Mean every different programming language have different operators for their use in JavaScript. Okay, let me just show you that what operators are we having in JavaScript. So these are your operators which are present in your JavaScript. Actually, we have a lot and many number of operators, but this is a general list of which we generally use for creating our programs in JavaScript. While writing your script, we generally use this operators. Okay, so I have created a table for you, so and with the example and result that how your this operators works and all. Means by seeing this image, you will get to know that how your operators and all is going to be work. Okay, so you can see that I have categorized your operator in four different categories, and my first category is of your arithmetic. So it is a time to memorize your fourth or fifth grade mathematics, in which you learn how to do addition, subtraction, multiplication or division, and how to find the remainder of your number. So this is your arithmetic operator is also known as mathematic operator, math operator. And second, we have a logical operator and your logical and comparison. These are the two operator which always give a value either true or false, means in the Boolean expression. Okay, because in Boolean expression, and I will be talking more about that in the video a little bit later only. And last one is your string, in which you all are familiar with the string, I guess, because your string uses the concatenation operator, which is your plus operator. You all know, as we are working in since from the last two or three videos, with the help of your concatenation operator, we are joining two or three strings together. So let's just start working with the arithmetic operator first. Okay. Okay, wait for a second, guy. Okay, let me start with the arithmetic operator, and then we will move on to the precedence and all. So as for now, we are just generally simply working with your operators. We are not including any precedence criteria as for now. So I have creating a variable, for example, name x, and I have assigned a value of 5 plus 6. Okay, and I'm gonna see this output in console. So I'm printing my x over there. So if you are not good. If you know math, then you can easily calculate what the answer should be. Means 5 plus 6 is your answer, your result should be of 11. So let's just check it out whether I write a correct code or not. So wait for a second. Okay. Go to inspector tool, find a console, and let me just zoom it out for you. And now you can see my 11. Okay, so I get a correct answer over here. I get a correct result over here. Okay, let's just work with some different operators of arithmetic only. So I have subtraction, multiplication, division, modulus, and your increment, decrement. So let's just start working with this. So I'm using your console over here because I'm going to show you live. Okay, that how your data is going to be changed when I do write a code over here. So I can create, I can directly write. Okay, I'm not creating any variable, I'm directly writing your code over here. Yes, I'm directly using your console. Okay, I'm not using any variable for this. So 10 minus 5. Okay, and second, I can write like console log. Okay, 10 into 5. But I can write like console. Sorry, console, and what I have 50 divided by 5. Sorry, guys. Okay, let's just check first. Let's just check this out. Okay, so run it, and now you can see that. Now you can see my answer, that my first answer is 10 minus 50. So 10 minus 50 is minus 40. So I get minus 40 over here. 10 into 5 is 50. I get 50 over here. 50 divided by 5 is equal to 10, so I get 10 over here. So you can see my all mathematics operators are working well. And now, guys, sometimes the case arises that you are looking for the remainder of a number. Means many times we are requiring that how using your remainder. So how to find a remainder of a number? So for that we have another operator named as your modulo. And how your modulo does means, what modulo operator is yours, nothing is your modulo operator is this, okay, the percentage sign. And what if I divide 10 by 3, then I'm going to get a remainder of your what, remainder of 1. Okay, because 3 times 3 is 9, and I'm going to gain my remainder of 1 over here. So let's just check it out. Okay, first line is minus 40, 50, and the last you can see 10 modulo 3 is going to give my 1. If I do like 15 divided by 4, then my remainder should be of 3, I guess. Yeah, wait. 4, 3, 12, and okay. So my remainder should be 3. So let's just check it out. Okay. Now you can see my remainder is 3 over here. Okay. So this is what your general basic operators are, means plus, minus, and modulo value. Next, just move on to your increment and decrement operator. These are new to you as you have not worked with them, but these are very easy to understand. So I'm creating a variable, for example, and I write like where x is equal to 5, okay? And I'm creating another variable, for example, y, and I can do okay. And guys, let me just show you one more thing over here, that how I can you can do this thing also, means you can create a number of variables. Declare a number of variables in the same line only. Okay, you can declare like this or whatever you want to declare. Okay, means these are the my variables that I created over here. So you can declare a number of variables in same line because your JavaScript is dynamic typing, so it will automatically take the data type when you assign a value to it. Okay, so there is no need to specifically define the declare your variable, but in other programming language there is necessary to. Means you can only define the same variable, declare the same variable, mean the variable which have same data type, you can only declare them in the same line. But in JavaScript, you can declare any number of variables in the same line. It is your choice. So, okay. So if I give a value of x is equal to 5, and I am giving a value of y is equal to plus plus x. Okay. So now my what, okay. And I'm storing z is equal to, no, not that, I'm just directly adding console dot log and y. So guys, what my output should be, can you guess? Okay, let me just tell you. that what is this plus plus is doing over here. Guys, you can see I have a value of x is equal to 5. Okay, so what plus plus means that it will going to increase my value of x by 1, then it will going to store the value in y. Okay, so means my previous value is 5, so it will first increase my value from 1. So my 5 is x is now having a value of 6, and 6 is going to be stored in your okay, let me just consider now for x. Okay, so 6 is going to be stored in my y. So let's just check it out. Okay, so you can see my first is what it does. If I do like console log, okay, and x over here, let me just delete this out. So now see, you can see over here I have one variable x. Okay, I having a value of 5. So what it does over here, that it print my 5 first. You can see my x value is printed over here, and then it increase the value of x by 1, means now my value of x is equal to 6, and it is stored 6 into y. So, and then let's now I print my x. So x is now having a value of 6, so 6 is printed over here, and my y is equal to x, so now I am having a y of value of 6 also. And what if I do it like, I'm removing this, right? What if I do it like plus plus? So now in previously we done the pre-increment. Pre-increment means first we increase the value and then we assign it to it, and this is your after means. Okay, so means this means your plus plus means x plus plus means it will first store the value of x, then it is going to increment it by 1. Okay, so you can see that my x is having a value of 5, so it will going to store 5 in y, then it's going to increase my value of x by 1. Okay, let me just change the order of for you to understand. Okay, you can see that my x is having a value of 5, so my 5 y is now having a value of 5, because this x value is assigned to my y first and then it increment the value of x by 1. Okay, so you can see first I get a value of y which is 5, because I wrote it like y is equal to x plus plus, so my value of x is first stored in y, and then it will, then the value of x is incremented by 1 after storing the value of x and y. Okay, so you can see that my x value of x is previously 5, so 5 is stored in y, and then it increment the value of x by 1, so in the next line I get output of 6. Okay, and similarly I can do it like this also. So what it going to do is it will first going to store my value in x, sorry, y, which is 5, so my y value should be 5, and so I get an output of 5, and the next line I will get output of because I decrease the value, so I will get 4. Okay, you can see I get over here 5 and I get 4. But what if I change the order, means I write like minus minus, so it will first decrease the value of y by 1, means x y 1, so your 4 is going to be stored in the y, and then I will get the, well, then my value of x is printed over here in the next line. So you can see both the values are same, means I will get like 4 4. Okay, you can see 4 4, because first it decreases the value of y, sorry, x by 1, so I get 4 over here, and 4 is stored in this, and then it print x value over here, so I get 4. Okay, so I hope you understand the working with your arithmetic operators, guys. So next, what we have next, I have your logical operators. Okay, sorry, next I have your logical operator. So let's just start working with your logical operator. I have three types of logical operator. First is your and means if any of my statement means if any of my con sorry statement no? if any of my condition is false, then it will going to give me the result of false. But and second means for and, it is necessary that my both operand should be true. Okay, means my both conditions should be true, then it will, then only it will going to give me the your true, otherwise in all cases it will going to be false. And this and second one is your or, and what or means In or you can say if any of the condition is false, then it doesn't care about it. If one of the in or if one of my condition is true, then it will going to give me the result in true only. It doesn't going to check whether the next condition is false or true. It will only check that if one condition is true, then my or operator is going to give me the value of true. Okay. The last logical operator is the not operator, and not does means you can say it is not means 3 is not equal to 2, 5 is not equal to 4, like that. Okay. And similarly, we have a comparison operator. Okay, let's just first talk about your logical operator only. So I'm just clearing this stuff from here and getting this, so I can write like I'm directly writing. I'm not creating any variable over here. Console log, and I'm writing my first condition, which is 5 is greater than 4, and 4 is greater than 5. So guys, what should be, what do you think? What the output should be? Okay, let me guess. My first, as we are working with AND operator, so you can see I have a one condition over here. 5 is greater than 4. This is true. But I got a second condition, which is 4 is greater than 5. But you can see that what I say in first, that AND operators only give us true when our both conditions are true. But you can see over here that this condition is true. 5 is greater than 4. But 4 is greater than 5 is false. So it is going to give me the result in false. You can see it gave me the output of false. Okay. I hope you understand. But let's see the case of your OR over here. Okay. So if I write like OR, and your OR operators mean that if any of these condition is true, then it will going to give me the answer in true only. So you can see that this condition is true. So it will not going to check this condition. It will directly going to give me the answer in true. Okay. So you can see I got answer in true. Okay. It doesn't care about the next condition. It just check my first and any of the condition. If one of my condition is true, then it will going to give me your true over here. Okay. And the last one is your not operator. So I can write like 5 not equal to 4. So this condition is true, so it is going to give me true. Okay, you can see here. But if I write like 5 is not equal to 5, then it is going to give me false. Okay, so I hope you understand the working with logical also. So now let's just move on to the last one, which is your comparison operators. So let's just check it out. So these are the 4 or 5 comparison operators we have in JavaScript. Not in JavaScript, in every programming language we have these operators only. So you can see we have equal, and this equal means because a single equal is used for assigning operator. We call that operator assigning for storing a value in variable. So we use two equal to sign for equating two values. Okay. Similarly, we have not equal to, so and not equal to we work in logical also. We have less than equal to, greater than equal to. Okay, so let's just start working with it. And guys, one more thing, you can't write it like equal to. Okay, I will show you in the here only what I saying to you, that if I have console log and I have written a condition means 4 is equal to 4, then what my output should be means is checking that 4 is equal to 4. It is checking this, so it is true, so it will going to give me the result in true. Okay, you can see. But if I write like 4 is equal to 5, means equal to means 4 is equal to 5, no, it is not, so it will going to give me false over here. Okay, so this is what your equal to means. Similarly, I can write like 4 is greater than 5, so what my output should be, my output should be false. So let's just check it out. You can see I get a false. But make sure guys that if you are using the less than equal to or greater than equal to, then first you have to put the your less than sign or greater than sign, then only you put the your equal to sign. You can't put like equal to then less than. This not make a sense in any programming language. I know we can make this sense, but in program the developer make it the operators like that only, that I can't write it like that. So you have to follow some rules for whenever you are working with less than or greater than, make sure you are putting the less than or greater sign in front of your equal to sign. So if I write like this, 4 is less than equal to 5, so let's just check our output. Yes, it is true. 4 is less than 5, so I get a true over here. Right? I can change it like 4 is greater than equal to 5, so I get a false over here, because 4 is not greater than equal to 5. And we are left with any or? Okay, we done all the operators, okay? A string. Okay, let's just discuss about string over there. So I can write a console log, and I have written, okay, for this I'm creating some variables over here. Where and x comma y, and I can write like x is equal to hello and y is equal to world. Let's just print this out. So you know that if we are joining two strings, because x and y are two strings over here, and now I want to join this string, so what I can do, I can directly write the variable names, and I can use the plus operator, which is also known as your concatenation operator in JavaScript, and not in JavaScript, in every programming language we use the plus operator as your concatenation operator. So what I done over here, I fetch my one string over here, one variable, which is my s, and it is having a data type of string. I have another string which is world, and I give some space in between them. So this is another string. So let's just check our output. I should get hello world in same line. Hello world. And you know, I think you know that how to what the output is. Okay. So now let's just move on to its precedence. Okay. So I'm moving its precedence. Okay. So let me just show you the precedence chart. Okay, I'm having internet. Okay, I'm having internet over here, so I can get like Mozilla. Okay, not this JavaScript precedence operator precedence. I will give you the link in description, so you will find. Okay, so this is a table given by created by your Mozilla Firefox. In the Mozilla Firefox website, official website, you will find this reference of operator precedence, in which you can see we have a number of operators over here. Here is the operators, means we have four different columns over here. You can see first is precedence, in which we have assigned the given the precedence value, and second is operator, and this is accessibility, means it tells us that how your operator is going to be act, means if I use any operators, then how my value is going to be stored or how the operation is going to perform. For example, if I using the equal to sign, then I wrote equal to, and I in left side I use my variable, so, and in right side I use some value. So my equal to sign, you can say it is left to right. Okay, you don't need to know about this accessibility. You can understand it when you are working with your operators. Okay, so it will be easier for you to understand. But from this website, you can see that we have a number of operators. Here is this individual operator, and you can see that we have been the highest precedence of your 21, and this is your parenthesis. Okay, and similarly, we have a number of operators over here, and with the different precedence over here. You can see we have a precedence of modulo precedence, means the multiplication in your there, you having a highest precedence in the arithmetic. You can see. Then we have a division, and this your modulo, then plus and minus. So these are the your operators. Okay, let's just discuss about one more operator, and then we will start working with your precedence. So I'm having one more operator over there, guys. So let's just go over here, and I can write like I have a operator. Okay, let's just minimize it. I can write like variable x is equal to hello. Okay, guys, you know that it is a string type. Okay, as I told you that this is a string type, but someone who don't know about that what the data type of this variable is, so how he or she can check this out, by using a console log and using an operator which is named as your type of. Okay, so you have to type in the word type of and then the variable name, and in the console you will get the data type of the variable. So if I run it, I made any mistake or something. Let me just wait for a second, guys. Console. Okay, type of X. Okay, it is working, but why is it not working over here? I don't get it. Means I just really don't get it, guys. Why it's not working over here? If we will check this out later on. So now if I just create one variable over here where x is equal to hello. So your type of x should be your string type. So let's say you can see over here that I got a value of string, but it's not working over here. I don't know why, guys. Maybe some errors arise, or I don't know what's just happening. Okay. Now it's working. Okay. Maybe it's because I use the double quotation mark in the console, because your latest browser might be not supporting your double quotation over here. So I get that problem. And now I'm getting a output. Okay. Let's just check this out again. It's working, guys. I don't know previously what the hell the code does. Now it's working well. I don't know, guys. Okay, leave. And now you understand this type of operator means. If I just create another variable like y, and I write a number over here, and now I want to check the type of y, so it will going to give me the result in the number. Equal to sign. Okay, so you can see that I got a type of y which is the number data type, so you will get output. Okay, let me just clear this out and show it to you again. Now you can see type of y is number. Okay, I hope you understand. Sorry guys, I made some mistakes previously, so the output is not as well I want it to be. And let's just start working with your precedence. Okay, so what precedence is? Okay, as you all know that precedence, I tell you that it will tell you that which operator is going to be evaluated first. So I show you the table, and you've seen over there that your grouping, which means the parenthesis having the highest precedence, so it will going to operate first. So if I create a variable, I'm not creating any value, I'm just directly using a console log over here, and I'm directly writing an operation over here. Means I'm writing like 4 plus 5 minus 8 multiplied by 2. Okay, so what do you think what the output should be? As you know that when we are checking the precedence, then we find that if you all work with your mathematics in 4 and 5, then you heard a name named as your BOD mass. Okay, and BOD mass means bracket and like that only. Okay, your BOD mass, you can see you have a bracket over there, you have a addition operator, multiplication operators, and like that. Okay, so it always follow a BOD mass over here. So I write it like 4 plus 5 plus minus 2, so it is going to follow the BOD mass. Okay, it will be easier for you to understand by BOD mass. I'm seeing this, guys, I'm talking about this BOD mass. Okay, so you can see I having a plus operator and minus operator, but you can see I'm having a high precedence of your multiplication. You can see over here my m is coming before the addition and the plus subtraction operator. So what it going to does over here, it will first multiply the two numbers, means I get like 8 into 2, I get a output of 16. Okay, and then I have addition operator, then it will going to perform the addition operator. So then it will going to perform like 4 plus 5, so 4 plus 5 I get like 9, Okay, I get like 9 over here plus what? Your 6 minus 16. Okay, because 9 minus 16. Then in last we are going to subtract it. So 9 minus 16, what is it? What the output should be? Means 6 from this side and 3 from this side. So my output should be 7. So let us check that out whether my this right code is correct or not. You can see that I get an output of minus 7, and so it is working well. Okay, and similarly I can make it like 5 plus, or I can do it like my minus of 50 minus 4. Yeah, 50 plus 4, 50 plus 5. Okay, so what it do, what it gonna do, because it will following your board mass over here. So first we are going to deal with your brackets, okay, because your bracket is having the highest precedence. Okay, so you can see that bracket, whatever the inside of bracket is going to be solved first. So I get a 54 over here, and previously we get like 9. First we solve this bracket, so I get 54. Okay, and you all know that previously when we solve this, so we get like minus 19, minus 16, and now I'm getting the inside of this is your minus of 54. So my output should be, let's just calculate. Okay, I know I'm okay. The for easier for you to understand. Okay, 9 minus 16, and minus 54. So my answer should be of minus 61. Okay, let's just check it out. I get an answer of minus 61. So you guys now understand that how your precedence is working and all. I hope you understand. So, and if you guys feel any problem, you can